Today, you're watching PTS English News. I'm Ethan Liu. Suspicions of insider trading have led to multiple raids and probes targeting the maker of Taiwan's domestic COVID-19 vaccine and its parent company. 18 people, including manager and chairman Zhang Shizhong and his relatives and friends, were questioned due to suspicious buying and selling of the company's stock before major news became public, with six of them released on bail.
Zhang Shizhong, the chair of both Medigen Biotech and its subsidiary, Medigen Vaccine Biologics, was questioned by prosecutors on the 29th. He was released on $300,000 bail on the 30th. Zhang's brother-in-law, Huang Ziliang, is a board director at Medigen Biotech. Huang and his wife, Zhang's sister, Zhang Ziling, were also questioned and released on $500,000 bail each. The company's former CFO, Ou Chao-chun, was also questioned and set to be released on $100,000 bail.
高端公司、基亚公司股票涉及内线交易、非常规交易等案件，经比对分析意见书、过滤投资人的交易资料之后， 约谈了相关的犯罪嫌疑人10多人到案。
Medigen made major performance-related announcements between February 2020 and July 2021, leading prosecutors to launch an insider trading investigation. They found that a company insider had friends and family purchase Medigen shares, which was confirmed by a whistleblower. Medigen's parent company is also suspected of cooking its books, while company officials are suspected of insider trading and non-arm's-length transactions. Of the 18 suspects questioned by prosecutors, 12 were released without bail. The KMT caucus is accusing the DPP of shielding Medigen, given that the case had been submitted to the prosecutor's office on 9 separate occasions before the elections, and prosecutors waited until after the elections to finally take action.
公司或个人任何违法的行为，我们尊重检调独立办案。
Medigen has released a statement saying two non-executive employees at its Zhubei factory may have violated securities laws with their personal investments, and this has nothing to do with the company whatsoever. The two were questioned by prosecutors at their homes and subsequently released. Medigen's parent company, meanwhile, says it is cooperating with the investigation.
The COVID-19 pandemic has reshaped people's daily lives and the global trade and economy, while many shipping giants raked in record-breaking profits due to soaring shipping prices. Evergreen Marine's profit this year is estimated to exceed 300 billion NT dollars, and there have been speculations that its employees receive an annual bonus worth up to 52 months of salary.
Many employees of Evergreen Marine were looking forward to being woken up by money. The amount did not disappoint. A total bonus of 2.33 million NT dollars was received, making other office workers envious.
整体绩效不错，盈余很好，那盈余很好又没有进一步的这个积极性的扩张运用的同时，大概把像今年的绩效比较好的发给员工作为年终奖金，我想是一个很合理的这个做法。
Evergreen Marine Shipping Company issued 40 months' salary for its year-end bonus in 2021. The company is estimated to make at least 300 billion NT dollars profit this year, which motivates the company to pay out a generous year-end bonus. Basic level employees with a monthly salary of 40 to 50,000 NT dollars is reported to receive a year-end bonus of 45 months' salary. The highest year-end bonus is reportedly up to 52 months' salary. Yangming Marine Transport has announced it will issue a 13-month year-end bonus, while Wanhai Shipping has not yet announced. Compared with the shipping industry's increasing profit, the aviation industry's year-end bonus has not yet returned to the pre-pandemic levels. EVA Air reported that its year-end bonus is 3 months' salary, and bonuses at China Airlines and Starlux are reported to be 1 month's salary.
整个所谓的出入境的这个人次回到疫情前千万人次的水准情况下，整个公司的获利状况才有办法带动年终奖金的反弹。不然，近期的这个解封的一个效应，可能只有短暂的一个这个效果，没有办法带动年终奖金的一个回温。The
large year-end bonus makes it difficult for Evergreen Marine employees to hide their good fortunes and maintain a low profile. Evergreen Marine may again be crowned this year's year-end bonus king. Whether it will maintain this year's prosperity for next year is of concern to all walks of life.
Taipei's meal program for seniors will end on December 31st. In response to calls for the program to continue, new Taipei City Mayor Chang Wan-an said a new announcement would be forthcoming.
我希望这个好的政策蒋市长能听到，让我们持续的办理。
Many seniors in Taipei look forward to sharing a meal with their friends and neighbors at their local borough office every week. Taipei's borough meal program, which spans 80 boroughs across the city, ends on December 31st. As many as 4,558 seniors will be affected.
不要让我们4,500多位的长辈在蒋万安蒋市长上任之后就共餐权益消失。其实我们在基层本来就已经听到了很多的心声。
那这个部分，我们对于长辈的照顾，绝对是我们非常重要重视的事情。接下来，社会局也会对外有清楚的说明，桌上长辈照顾的权益绝对不受损。According to Taipei City Councilor Jin Shupei, Zhang Wan-an is clueless about city affairs, and Deputy Mayor Lin Yihua needs to report to work as soon as possible so that seniors won't be sacrificed. Taipei's NT$1,500 elder subsidy is coming back next year. Ke Wenzhe, who canceled the subsidy, questions where the money will come from.
我想这是市民共同的期待，而且我们对于长辈的照顾，绝对是最重要的责任。
The subsidy program will cost the city NT$170 million. Zhang says his election promise will be realized.
The TAIEX moved marginally up and closed at 14,137.69 points on its last trading day of 2022. That translates into the index's second worst annual drop of more than 4,000 points and an average loss of more than NT$1 million for stock investors.
U.S. stocks finished up on Thursday, pushing Taiwanese stocks to rise 98 points on the last trading day of the year. The rising TAIEX index was driven by semiconductors, electronics, and shipping stocks. The highest intraday rise was 163 points, as the TAIEX reached 14,248 points. TSMC also rebounded, rising NT$10.5, an increase of more than 2%.
科技股这一波跌得相当的深，那台积电呢今天是领军上攻，不过就是说成交量的一个部分呢是。 比较萎缩，毕竟呢后面有连假三天，所以在量缩的情况之下呢，估计指数就算有涨，幅度也不会太大。Looking
back at this year's Taipei stock market, after hitting a historical high of 18,619.6 points on January 5th, the TAIEX has fallen continuously, slumping more than 22% for the year. Foreign investors have also retreated from Taiwan due to rising inflationary pressure and violent interest rate hikes. They have sold more than NT$1.2 trillion in stocks for 2022, a new record high.
今年以来，就是因为通膨的影响，全球的升息循环，加上有很多央行，就开始紧缩货币供给，缺乏资金的支持，那台股呢要上涨就不容易。加上11月外销订单，衰退的幅度超过20%，那台湾呢制造业的比重还是蛮高的。 所以说呢，跟出口相关的这些制造业，如果接单的情况不理想，接下来就是它的获利表现可能就不理想。那这些基本面的问题，也是多少会反映到股市。Investors
are concerned about the government's two major protection measures, including the National Financial Stabilization Fund and the ability to continually ban short selling of stocks that fell by more than 3.5% the previous day. Both measures will remain in the market for the time being. The new Taiwan dollar rose along with other Asian currencies, such as the RMB. It rose above the NT$30.7 barrier to the U.S. dollar exchange rate, reaching a maximum of NT$30.65, an appreciation of 8.2 cents, a new two-week high.
Now let's take a look at more international news of the day. Pelé, the Brazilian footballer and a global icon, died at the age of 82 due to multiple organ failure. He was the all-time leading scorer in football history and the only player to win the World Cup 3 times. Power outages were reported across Ukraine after Russia fired scores of missiles in one of Moscow's largest assaults, targeting Kyiv and other Ukrainian cities. The court in military-ruled Myanmar once again convicted Aung San Suu Kyi of corruption, leaving the 77-year-old Nobel Peace Prize winner with a total of 33 years to serve in prison. A warehouse fire in Taichung's Fengyuan killed 4 and injured 2 on the night of December 29th. The city says the warehouse was an illegal structure, and it is also investigating the owner of labor violations.
Firefighters are doing everything they can to put out this factory fire, which erupted on the night of the 29th at a two-story warehouse on Taichung's Dongzhou Road. A total of 26 fire trucks and 66 firefighters were sent to the scene. 9 employees were painting floorboards inside the building when the fire broke out. 5 escaped, but 4 that were found on the second floor were pronounced dead at the hospital. Investigators believe sparks from an electric cable ignited the fire when they came into contact with paint solvent fumes. In addition to the 4 workers that were killed, a 5th worker, surnamed Huang, suffered burns to 50% of his body, and a 6th worker was treated for smoke inhalation. The warehouse belonged to a company called Yasuda and was not registered and had never been inspected. It was also situated illegally on farmland. The city has given the company 14 days to remove the warehouse. If the company fails to do so, the city government will tear it down. Labor officials are also investigating whether the employees that were on site at the time of the fire were being forced to work excessive overtime.
Thank you for watching PTS English News. I'm Ethan Liu. Happy New Year, and I'll see you next time in 2023.